It's election day in an American town, but everything is going wrong. There's a bomb threat at the local post office, the 911 call center has been hacked and now offline, traffic lights in the city are malfunctioning, and fake stories about COVID outbreaks among poll workers are circulating all over the internet. The town is Adversaria, which thankfully doesn't actually exist, but it's the main character in a simulation organized by the information security company Cyberreason, called Operation Blackout.
I think the attention for the most part has been by security professionals on how do you hack the electoral rolls? How do you hack the machinery of voting? That's important, it's not all there is.
We felt it was a very narrow-minded view of the election process, but the entire process was much more vulnerable.
The purpose behind Operation Blackout is to game it out and you simulate. And so we say, let's think about the unthinkable so that we're ready.
It's not a zero-sum game. It's possible that you both could do very well at this or do very poorly, as we've seen in the past in some instances.
Elections happen at a local level. They happen in cities and at the state level. And what we want to make sure is that the folks who are going to be administering that, volunteers, local law enforcement, state and city governments, that they are aware of what might happen and that they're as prepared as can be.
In order to really shift the focus on election security from the very technical question of how do you secure the voting machines to a much broader question of how do you secure the voting process. So the way we envisioned it was, let's create a tabletop simulation.
For the simulation, there's a red, blue, and white team. Jonathan leads the red team, which takes on the hacker role and comes up with ways to undermine the election. The blue team is composed of the people who would actually be responding to these threats in real time. We can't reveal who they are for security purposes, but the team includes federal, state, and local law enforcement and other local officials. And Sam is the white team. He sits between the red and the blue and coordinates the moves.
Let's give them a little hint. FBI reports, dark web, showing interest in private sector delivery services.
The simulation usually happens in person, but this year the pandemic has relegated the event to Zoom.
In one of the simulations, we did videos of the candidates really doing things that would play very wrong with their base using deepfake technology.
Let's replace this one with a deepfake concession speech.
We looked at creating a bomb threat to dramatically change traffic patterns. If you spend 3 hours on the way back home, you're not going to go and then go out and vote again. You'll think to yourself, my vote doesn't really matter. I'll just stay home today.
The blue team have a completely different objective. It's not just the opposite. It's about public safety. They are law enforcement for the most part. But there are things they can do to change the game and to make it so that they can also protect democracy.
The law enforcement first and foremost priority is public safety. Your number one concern is how do I keep people safe? Only your second priority is how do I keep the integrity of the process?
The post office has suffered a bomb threat.
There's an anthrax scare.
He's doing a physical attack on the vote sorting machinery.
The president plans to discount mail-in votes.
Well, here's what I'm saying is tell citizens to expect that we will not be able to finalize results for several days, regardless of what any particular candidate says. This is our last turn. We'll see what happens.
In the moment when something bad happens and you have a crisis, you get an adrenaline response. It's fight or flight. And that's a poor time to be making decisions. So here's a chance for people to sit down around a table in a fun, if tense, setting. And eventually in a simulation, the walls fade out and you feel like you're in it. So let's give them that chance and let's give them a chance to get to know each other.
We're so used as individuals to segment the problem into discrete domains, we don't see how they interrelate. As security researchers, we are constantly living in those connections. So what are the non-obvious links we're missing is absolutely something that can be used to protect the system.
The reality is we can't forecast what's going to happen on election day. And that's really the point of this simulation. To get the people running our elections to expect the unexpected and react to threats in a productive way, all in an effort to preserve our democracy.
So the end result here, I have to say, Danny, you and the blue team, safety first mission was accomplished. And I think smart moves at the end really made a difference.
Hopefully the day of, they know who to call and they know what to do. And they're like, hey, we gamed this out such that by the time it arrives, it's a reflex. Because no one has seen an election like we expect the 2020 presidential election to be. The stakes are high for 2020. And frankly, this is the game to win.
Thanks for watching. For more great stories about people and ideas that are changing the world, subscribe to Freethink now.